Hi everyone, welcome back to Crochet Tutorials. In this video, I'm going to show you how to make this astonishingly cool Harlequin blanket. And it's using these really awesome crochet blocks, which are the diamond shape. Technically, they're a rhombus, but obviously they're placed in this diamond shape. This blanket is massive. It is 92 diamonds in this blanket, and they are a 10 inch diamond. So, you know, they're a little bit over 10 inches, maybe 10 and a half by about 6.5 inches. So, it is a massive blanket. It is a queen size bed blanket, and I made it for my daughter. It isn't quite finished because I've left one of these joins to video for you, and of course I need to complete the border. However, I wanted to pop this into a video and show you how to make these elements, because there are a couple of elements in this blanket. As you can see from these photos, there are these diamonds, and there are actually also, if you can bring that down, this is the top edge of the blanket that the border is incomplete at the moment. There are these triangles that sit between the diamonds on every row. There's a diamond below them, and there's these diamonds on either side. So these triangles need to be placed in the top to make that top straight. There's also an edge piece, which you can see in this photo here, and a tiny little corner piece. And this is an example of the edge piece. And they sit between the diamonds like this, to again make that edge completely flat or straight on the side of the blanket. So these ones go, the little triangles go at the top and the bottom, and these ones go at the side. And the little tiny corner piece that you can see there is actually just half of this. So diamonds can be a little bit tricky because you are increasing all the way up the diamond and then decreasing towards the top. And again, same with this, except you only increase and decrease on one side. This side needs to remain straight. So how do we do that? I've got a couple of charts here that have been drawn up, not by me, they've been drawn up by someone much better at art than me. And these I have taken a couple of photos of and will put them in so you can screenshot them. Alternatively, I'll see if I can upload them to Ravelry and put them in a link down in the description. But of course, I will be doing a tutorial on how to do this magnificent join. And as you can see, it just completely completes this diamond pattern. But let's have a look first at how to make these diamonds. They're really easy, but they can be a bit tricky. So let's get started. Okay, I'm using a 10 ply. It probably is actually quite a chunky 10 ply, but whatever you use, just grab an appropriate hook. I'm using this 10 ply with the 5.5 mil, and it is the hook that I've used to make all of these diamonds. Essentially, what you do when you start is you chain 4. And you can see on the chart, I don't know if you've ever used a crochet chart, but this is the beginning. And you've got here a chain 4 and then a double crochet into that first chain. So essentially, this is a double crochet created by the chain 3 and a double crochet there. And then we're going to increase in every edge stitch. So the next round will increase in both of these stitches, but the next row will only increase in the ends. And every time you go up, you increase in your first and your last stitch. So chain 4 and then double crochet into that first chain, and that gives us 2 double crochets. And then we need to chain 3 and turn, and then we're going to double crochet directly into that stitch that we made, the double crochet that we made before we turned, and we've just chained out of it, we're going to double crochet back into that same stitch. And then put two double crochets into the top of this chain three. So from our beginning chain four, that's the top of that chain three now. So our first round will have two double crochets and our second row will have four. And that is what the chart tells us here. Because we're increasing by two each round, each row, our second row will have six and then eight and so on. So then we just chain three again, turn, and put that double crochet back in that stitch that we just chained out from, and then just a double crochet in the next stitch, a double crochet in the next stitch, and two in the top of the chain three. And as we're increasing, we'll always be placing two in the top of the chain three. So we've got our six, and that always includes the chain. So chaining three again, turning, and doing the same thing, crocheting directly into that stitch, putting a crochet, a double crochet into each stitch across, each stitch across, and then two into the chain three. And that is eight double crochets across in that row. And we're just going to do the same thing for every row. Chain three, turn, place a stitch straight back in that place we just chained from. One into every stitch across. And two into the chain three, the top of the chain three at the end. And when we continue in that method, we'll get this lovely diamond shape that will continue as long as we continue to put two in the beginning and two in the end. As per the crochet chart, there's always two in the beginning and two in the end. So we keep doing that for 10 rounds. One, two, three, four, five. We've just done five. I've got five to go, and I'll see you when we get to the end of the 10th round. Okay, so at the end of the 10th round, your diamond should look like this. And this is a triangle. So it is one of those spacing triangles that go across the top and the bottom edge. So if you're making those, this is where you'd stop. You'd just finish that off at this position. But for the diamond, we need to make a decrease, a pointy edge. And that is really easy, but it can be a little confusing. So if you have a look on the chart here, you can see that we've chained three every round or every row, and that is the height of a double crochet. On the top portion of this triangle, when we're, or the diamond, when we're decreasing, we're only chaining two each row, and that is because we're going to be doing a double crochet two together. So this chain two plus the loop for the top of the double crochet two together makes this effectively the right size. If you actually did do a chain three, and then double crocheted into this next stitch. So you chain out of that one, double crochet into the next one, you'll actually find that you won't be decreasing. So you do need to do this chain two. And it really is as simple as that. We chain two and then turn. And we're not going to go back into this first stitch here, the one we just chained from. We need to yarn over and double crochet into that next stitch. And then we're just going to double crochet both of those together. So by chaining two, you make two loops, and then this last loop at the top of that two together becomes the final loop. And then we just work across the piece as we have for every row until we get to the end. And on this first row 11, you actually do need to work into your chain three from the previous round, because we've got a chain three that we chained up at the beginning of that previous row. So we need to work into that, but that will actually be the last time we work into a chain three on, or a, work into a chain at all on the diamond. So just continue to work across, a double crochet into the top of every stitch all the way across, and until we get to that end. And then we're going to, with these last two stitches, so we've got a stitch here and we've got our chain three, so they're our last two stitches. We're going to double crochet into this first stitch and hold it there, and then yarn over again and go into the top of the chain three and yarn over and pull through two, and then yarn over and pull through three to do that double crochet two together. Chain two and turn. And again, we're not going to go into this stitch that we just came out of. We're going into the next stitch to do our two together. And then we're going to crochet all the way across. And on this row and every subsequent row now, it will be a little bit different because we don't have a chain up to work into the way we just did then. But we do have two stitches at the end, remembering that that chain two that we did at the beginning of round or row 11 is capped by a loop from the double crochet two together. So we're not actually going to be working into that chain. And we've got our two stitches on the end. So we're going to ignore this chain because these two loops you can see here, this loop, just grab that out, this loop and this, they're the tops of the stitches there. So this one and this one are our last two stitches. This is simply our chain two, which is effectively just the body of a double crochet. So we wouldn't go into the body of a double crochet, and we won't now. So we're going to just go into that as we normally would, yarn over and pull through two, then yarn over again, go into the next stitch, yarn over and pull through two, and then yarn over and pull through three. And you can see there that that has started to bring this diamond in. And then again, we'll chain two, we'll turn, we won't go into this that we've just chained from, we'll go into the next one and do our two together. And then repeat that same process. I'll meet you at the end of this round. I won't make you watch all these stitches. So again, here we are at the end of the round. We've got our final two stitches, ignoring the chain two, and we're just going to double crochet those two together to turn them into one stitch, because we're decreasing now by a stitch on either side, just the way that we increased by a stitch on each side here. We're decreasing by a stitch on each side now. So we do the same every row. Chain two, go into the next stitch, not that stitch that we just chained from, go into the next stitch and double crochet all the way along until we get to our final two stitches, ignoring that chain two, and double crochet those together. Chain two and do the same till we get to the other side. All the way up for 10 more rows. So these are 20 rows, the diamonds. There's 10 of increase and 10 of decrease. And I'll meet you when we get to the second last row. So at the beginning of the second last row. Okay, so here we are at the beginning of the second last row. Just as we do normally, we're going to chain two. Don't know what happened there. But we're going to chain two. And double crochet those first two stitches together. And then we'll double crochet these stitches together. And you can see on the chart that is what this says. Double crochet the first two together and double crochet the second two together. And so from there, we can see at the top, all we've got is two loops. So we're just going to chain two, turn, and go into that final stitch and double crochet. And that, let me just zoom out a bit. That is our diamond. And it is as easy as that. As long as you remember, you're increasing in every first and last stitch on the first 10 rounds, and then you're decreasing in every first and last stitch on the second 10 rounds. And it is important to remember to chain four at the beginning, and you'll always chain out and double crochet into the same stitch at the beginning and at the end, putting two double crochets. And generally at the end, you're always working into a chain. So you're putting your two double crochets into your chain three, two double crochets into the chain three. And it's as simple as that. So the other piece is a little bit more tricky, and that is simply because we have to keep one edge straight. So how do we do that? The chart is really helpful. It is the same. We're doing a chain four with a double crochet. We're chaining three up each round or each row, and when we're decreasing, we're only chaining two. But you will see here that even though we're on the second half, the decrease half of the diamond, there's sometimes that we're chaining three, and that's for the straight edge. We'll always chain three on the straight edge and then chain two when we need to decrease. So let's get started on that. Okay, again, I'm using the same yarn as I just did for that one. And we're going to chain four. I'll just zoom in a bit. And then place a double crochet into the first chain the way we did for the diamond. And then we're going to chain three, turn, and put a double crochet back into that same space, the way we would for the increase portion of the diamond, because This is now going to be our increase side. And then we're going to just put one double crochet into the top of that chain three. And you can see already that this side's straight, this side is increasing. And then we need to chain three, turn. And because we're not increasing on this side, we're not placing a double crochet back in this same stitch. We're going to go into the next stitch and double crochet. And then we're going to put two into the chain three on this side. So it just takes a bit of remembering which is your increase side and which is your straight edge, but you'll get there. And remember that we've chained three now, we've turned, this is our increase side, so we need to increase by putting a stitch in that same stitch and work across until we get to our flat edge side, which is the chain three here, and just place one double crochet in there. And you can see now it's a little bit more clear which is your flat edge side and which is your increase side. So we're chaining three, we're turning, we're not increasing, so we're skipping this, and then we're going straight into that. Putting a crochet in each stitch across and increasing into that chain three by placing two double crochets in there, chaining three to come out, turning, increasing because that's our increase side, and working across. That's our last stitch before the flat edge, and we just need to place one double crochet into that. And you will see that there will be these little gaps. It looks like there's a gap, and it happens. You'll see on this one that it has a small gap there. It's not a big deal, because when you end up joining these together, you're going to go into that gap with your stitches anyway, so I wouldn't worry about it at all. On the flat edge, we chain three, we turn, we don't increase, we go into the next stitch and just work across and increase in that chain three, which can sometimes be quite hard to get into, but I tend to use brute force. And that is how we work that. So we've got 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. So we just need to follow that exact process up until we get to 10. So chaining three, we're on the increase side, increasing, working across in each stitch, and we only need three more rows. Until we have to start to decrease. So just on our flat edge, just one double crochet into the chain, chain out, turn, not increase because this is our flat edge, and work across. And I'll see you when we get to the end of the 10th round. Okay, so that's the end of the 10 rounds. So from now we need to decrease, but we're on our flat edge currently. So this means that we'll always be chaining three on our flat edge. two, three on our flat. And again, not increasing, but just going into the next stitch to start working across. And as with the full diamond, on this row 11, we will need to double crochet two together into one stitch and the chain from the previous row. So here we are at the end. We've got our stitch and our chain from the previous row. So we need to just double crochet those two together, the same way we did in the full diamond. And then we're going to chain two. And essentially now we are going to be working into the next stitch, so not that stitch that we've just chained from, but we're going to work into that next stitch and do the double crochet two together. And then just work across. That double crochet two together like that is what we'll do every decrease now. But of course, we're not decreasing at both ends the way we were with the diamond. And then just one double crochet into that chain three to keep that edge flat. A chain three, turn, don't increase. There's a plane flying over. Or maybe it's a helicopter, I don't know. I think it's a plane. And then as we're at the end here, the same thing with the diamond, our last two stitches are going to be a double crochet, those two together, ignoring that chain two. And then because we're on our decrease now edge, we're chaining two and we're turning. We're going into that following stitch and decreasing. And then just working across as usual. And it can get quite tricky actually when you get to the end of this, because you think, have I got enough stitches here to work? And I'll show you what I mean in a second. Double crochet into that chain three to maintain that straight edge. Another chain three to maintain the straight edge. Working across. Until we get to our final two stitches where we're going to double crochet two together to decrease, chain two, turn, decrease, and work into these remaining stitches, and then the chain three to maintain that flat. Chain three out of that, turn, and then we've got our two stitches here. So that's what we need to work into. So we've got our chain three, two stitches, and now we're going to double crochet these two together. So that's what we have just done, our chain three, our two stitches, and double crochet two together. So now, I'll leave that off. For what we need to do now, we need to decrease on this side, chain two, turn, and go into the next stitch, and those two are double crochet two together, and then we work into this next stitch and place a double crochet in the chain three. which is this round here. So chain two, double crochet two together, a stitch, and a double crochet into the chain three. Now we're going to be chaining out, and all we've got left is to do a double crochet two together in that round. So we're chaining three along the flat side, and you can see here all we've got left is these two loops. So we're doing a double crochet two together, and this is what I mean by, you might think, hang on, I don't have any thing to do here, but what we're going to do is just chain two, turn, and place a double crochet into the top of that chain three, because we need that to maintain our straight edge and to give us only two stitches at the top. So if you're confused, and I know it could be confusing, the crochet chart is the best way to go. Making sure that you're doing a decrease on only one side and maintaining your chain three double crochet flat edge on the other. It is quite simple once you get the hang of it, but it can be confusing once you're starting. Now again, that little tiny corner piece that I mentioned that sits down in those bottom corners of this blanket is just the first 10 rows. So once you finish your increasing, before you start the decreasing of this piece, that is where you'd stop with that one. So that is those pieces. I do hope you make these. They are an absolutely wonderful building block. As you can see, I'm completely in love with it. I've made, I don't know, 100 and something of these pieces. So they are just wonderful. And I'm going to film the tutorial for how to do this magnificent join very shortly. I'll see you then. Thanks for joining me. Have a great day.